Welcome back. Today we're going to be doing some partial derivative problems. The first one that we're going to do is f of x, y, z equals x squared times y cubed times z to the 4. And all that partial derivatives means is that we're going to be taking the derivative for every single variable in the problem. So since there are three variables, we're actually going to have to take the derivative three times, once for each variable, and it's going to be a separate equation for each one. So we'll go in order. The first one we'll look at is x, and the notation for a partial derivative looks like this. This weird squiggly thing, f, the weird squiggly thing, x. So f you get from here, so if this is, you know, h of x, y, z, then this becomes an h. And then x is the first variable we're gonna do. So we'll go ahead and say, now when we're taking, and when we take the partial derivative here with x, we say that we're taking the partial derivative with respect to x, is how people call it. Then we'll take the partial derivative with respect to y, then with respect to z. So looking at x, the way that we take the partial derivative with respect to x, while still having these other variables in the equation, is we treat the other variables like they're constants. And what I like to do, and you'll get faster and faster at it in your head, but the way that I like to do that, just to make it really obvious, because sometimes it's hard to understand how to hold those constants, especially when you're first starting out, I like to actually put a constant in there for those numbers and then simplify the equation and then take the partial derivative so I can see it. So what I would do here, for example, we're talking about holding y and z constant as if they were a constant number, like 2 or 3. So let's go ahead and put 2 in for y and z here. If we did, we would have x squared times 2 cubed times 2 to the 4th, right? Because we plugged in 2 for y and for z, okay? So since we're keeping these constant, this is how the equation would simplify. So if you multiply this out, let's see, this would actually be x squared times 8, and this would be times 16, so this would be 80 and 48, so this would be x squared times 128, right, if you simplified that. So what would be, if we were taking the derivative of this normally, we would be looking at 128 x squared. We would take the derivative of this, and we would multiply 2 times the coefficient, which is 128, so that would be, what, 256. So the derivative of this would be 256x, right? So what I'm hoping that you can see from this is that it's exactly the same thing. We're going to hold these two things constant, and they are going to be like a coefficient, and this 256 stays. So this is actually going to be, and let's go ahead and write out the answer and then we'll compare them. You're going to multiply this 2 out in front here. So it's going to be 2x and then y cubed z to the 4. That's going to be the answer for the partial derivative. And I hope that you can see the relationship here. We multiplied the 2 on the x squared out in front, just like we did here. We brought this 2 out in front, and we ended up with a single x, just like we ended up with a single x here. And we left y cubed and z to the 4th because they were absorbed into the coefficient here. They're like, because they're constants and they're multiplied together, they're part of the coefficient. They're like part of this 2, which is why they get left in this equation. Let's go ahead and do y so that we can see another example and hopefully we'll start to understand. So when we take the partial derivative with respect to y, as you might expect, it's going to be partial derivative of f with respect to y, just like we did for x here. So now with y,
We're going to actually be holding, oh, I hope you guys can hear that fire truck. So with y, we're going to be keeping x and z constant. So they're going to be like the coefficient as well. You could plug in numbers for them and go through the same exercise, but they're like the coefficient, so they're going to stay exactly the same because they're multiplied here with the y. So we're not even going to touch them. Remember, we didn't touch y cubed, we didn't touch z to the fourth. So x and z this time are going to stay as well. So all we're really looking at is the y, and we're going to do the same thing we did with x, take the derivative of y. So we're going to get that 3 out in front, and then y squared. Right? 3y squared is the derivative of y cubed. So we took the derivative, and then the x squared and the z to the fourth are just going to stay. So that's the derivative with respect to y. I left the space because when you take the partial derivative, you always like to keep the variables in alphabetical order. So I could have written 3y squared, x squared, z to the fourth, but we like to always keep them x, y, z in order. So we'll go ahead and do the same thing here for z. So it's going to be the partial derivative of f with respect to z. And we will go ahead and leave x squared and y cubed. We're not touching them because they're like part of the coefficient. They stay. So we'll go ahead and say x squared, y cubed. And then we take the derivative of z here. So the derivative, of course, we subtract 1 from the exponent. So 4 minus 1 is 3. And the 4 gets multiplied out in front, so it comes out here. So our answer with respect to z is actually 4x squared, y cubed, z cubed. And your final answer is a three-part answer. If you're asked to take the derivative of this function, or the partial derivative, because there are three variables, you need each one of these equations, and you would want to write all three of these down on your homework or on your test because your answer is actually all three of these. So there you have it.